Hi everyone, it's Liz here. Coming to you from my chair, not from the piano. But never worry, a piano concert is on its way now. I thought I would sit here and explain why I'm not sitting at the piano. My cat is trying to tell you. Basically, this is a special V.E. Day concert for you. Usually I will be posting one concert a week on a Sunday, but as today is V.E. Day, I'm recording this the day before, but it's a bank holiday. It's also my auntie's birthday, so happy birthday! It's a bit of a different feel this year because nobody's really celebrating VE Day as a party. People are obviously having their own little celebrations, but with the lockdown and with people having traumatic times and family deaths and things like that, it doesn't feel right to be like partying, but also we should be celebrating for the war heroes, for the people who fought in the Second World War. That is what VE Day is celebrating, 75 years since the end of the Second World War. Now, the reason that I decided to do this special one is a tribute to my granddad. He fought in the Second World War. He was based at the Henlow camp, RAF Henlow. He was in the RAF and he was a carpenter. He got deployed to Egypt for the Second World War. And when he came back, he married my grandma. And it was lovely. And I'm so glad that I've heard so many wonderful stories. He lived his entire life after the war with shrapnel of a bullet behind his eye. He got shot and they said it was safer not to take it out, which I'm glad they didn't because he might not have been there. Sadly, he passed away in 2009, and Monday just gone was his 11-year anniversary of his passing. And because he was my war hero, I thought I would dedicate most of the concert to him. So I hope you enjoy, and I'm going to explain before each piece why I've chosen it, just briefly. And happy VE Day. So I chose this piece. It actually was a request when I was doing the challenge, but it's also in keeping with VE Day. It's Moonlight Serenade, Glenn Miller, and it's a lovely piece. I couldn't find a piece of music that was a full-on like song, so I had to improvise slightly with the accompaniment, but hopefully you like it. I love that piece so much. So yeah, this is Moonlight Serenade. Thank you. change of scenery. this next piece is a piece that it may sound a bit morbid, but to me it's not. It's called Etude, Opus 10, number 3, and it's sadness, basically, by Chopin. I played this piece at my granddad's funeral, and I was at the age where I wanted to do something and give him a good send-off, and he always loved me playing the piano, so I chose to play, and trying to pick a piece to play was hard, but that one just seemed right. It's, although it's called Sadness, it's a pretty piece, and it always reminds me of my granddad, so I haven't played it for a very long time, but when I did, it was just came straight back to me, and it didn't make me as sad, because a long time's passed, and it's just nice to hear it again, so here it is. The next song is a very special song. It's called I Won't Send Roses. I don't know if many of you know it. It's from Mac and Mabel, which is a musical. It's written by Jerry Herman. You might think it's an odd choice, but for me, it just screams to me my granddad. And yes, it's V.E. Day, but it's also celebrating the war heroes, which is my granddad. So the reason I chose it is because my granddad, as many close friends and family will know, spent his last few years battling cancer, and he sadly passed away in 2009 in a care home. And most of the last few months of his life, he was put on, made comfortable on a high dose of morphine. He didn't know where he was or who some people were, and he was pretty ill. But on the last ever day that we spent with him, we took him in the garden, and although he was very unwell, he wanted to go out. So we took him in the wheelchair, and he was reminiscing with us about things, almost like he wanted to tell us as much as he could. And he started to sing, and he never sang that much. And he sang this, a few lines of this song, and it said, "I won't bring roses to your door." And he sang it, he said he used to sing it to my grandma, who is no longer with us either. And I didn't think much of it. And then 10 years went by, and last year I was like, I wonder if that song is real. Like, I've never really looked it up. And of course I put into Google the lyrics, "I won't bring roses to your door." Nothing came up. But then I put, "I won't bring roses to your door, old song," and it came up with variations of that. And "I won't send roses," I found, put into YouTube, and as soon as it started playing, I was just gone. I was like, that's the song, that's the tune he sang. So he only got one or two words slightly wrong, but it was the song. And it's such a lovely song. I thought I would add that in because it's special to me. I don't even know if my mum remembers that, but only me and my mum were there. So it's always stayed with me, that song. And if you want to look up the words, I will just suggest you go and look for them. It's called "I Won't Send Roses" by Jerry Herman. It's a nice piece. So, yeah. Now, this piece, I think everyone will know. It's not from the wartime era, which a few of these, well, most of these aren't. But I thought it was appropriate considering what day it is, V.E. Day. And all the, there's not many people got their grandparents left. They have, they're very old now. And I know a lot of people like this song. It's a Robbie Williams song. It's Angels. I love it. I've been playing it for years. I just think that all our heroes, our war heroes, are now angels. And I think anyone who's still alive who fought in the war will be an angel because they did so much for our country. So this is Robbie Williams' Angels.
Thank you.
this piece. I added in at the last minute. I wasn't sure whether to do it, but I thought actually I would, because we're acknowledging recently, in recent years, the Holocaust survivors. I have Jewish roots, and I think it's important that we don't forget those that died that weren't just soldiers, they were human beings, and the Second World War took a lot of people, and it was just so sad. I remember once at school we were doing about that era and the Holocaust, and we were we watched half of Schindler's List in a history lesson. We weren't allowed to watch the full one for obvious reasons, but one day I did watch it, and it's so sad, but the music to it is also sad. But I decided that we need to acknowledge everyone from the war. So this is by John Williams. This is the theme from Schindler's List. Yeah. Thank you for watching. I am just sitting here editing the video and realised I didn't close it out at all, which was a bit crazy. I hope you all celebrate in some way V.E. Day. I know it's different to most celebrations, but I'm sure we'll, in our own ways, find some way of celebrating. I hope you enjoyed this concert. I will be going back to my regular concerts as of next Sunday, with a host of lots of different music, more upbeat probably as well. And yeah, that's it. So I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.